Good afternoon and welcome to the Seven Hills Fellowship Weekly Devotional. We started these devotionals all the way back in the end of February, I think, maybe the beginning of March, but it was right after my cancer. And part of what I wanted to do was, in the midst of COVID and the coronavirus, I wanted to have a midweek opportunity to be able to address the church and to be able to, frankly, point you towards God during the middle of the week while we were waiting to get back into corporate worship. Now, last week, we jumped into a new series of these weekly devotionals where I started unpacking what we call our ministry plan. Our ministry plan is, to the church world, what a business plan would be in the business world. Typically, a business plan or a ministry plan maybe begins with the story of how an entity came into existence. And so last week, I told the story of how Kristen and I moved here to Rome, Georgia, how we started Seven Hills Fellowship, and how we became the church that we are today. So if you'd like to hear that story, you can check on the weekly devotional from last week. It'll be either on Instagram or on YouTube. Now, before we jump into today's devotional, let me make a couple quick announcements. One, we will continue to live stream on Sundays at 10:15 a.m. We're actually going to continue providing this even after we go back to corporate worship on Sunday mornings. We're going to continue offering that, but for those of you who have been tuning into the live stream on Sunday morning, we'd love to invite you to keep coming back and to continue to worship God together, especially until we're able to do that corporately on Sunday mornings. Next announcement, because we haven't been meeting corporately indoors, we wanted to provide the people of Seven Hills Fellowship an opportunity to worship corporately outdoors. And so we've been offering the Saturday night Lord's Supper service from 7 to 7:30 p.m. out at Ridge Ferry. And so I'd love to invite you out to that. We have been spending time singing and praying and reading scripture and obviously receiving the Lord's Supper. This Saturday night, Ryan Stanger and David Slade will be reading each of the sections of the liturgy and will be leading us through that service. Last and probably the biggest piece of announcement is the session met last night. And I want to let you know that we are working on a plan to return to Sunday morning as soon as possible. I want to be careful not to overpromise and underproduce, but just know that we are headed back to corporate worship as soon as possible. And as soon as we feel like it's appropriate, I'll publicize that date. So just keep a lookout for that and be in prayer for us as we seek to make these decisions, not only for what is best for our church, but for the people of Rome, Georgia as well. Now, jumping back into this discussion of the ministry plan, one of the things that is part of either a business plan or a ministry plan is a vision statement. And that vision statement is the thing that you're shooting for or aiming towards. And so, for example, Papa John's vision statement is better ingredients, better pizza. Bono, the lead singer of U2, started a ministry fighting poverty, and their vision statement is making poverty history. Our particular vision statement is that Seven Hills Fellowship wants to be a church working towards the flourishing of our city. Let me read that one more time. Seven Hills Fellowship wants to be a church working towards the flourishing of our city. Now, if you've been around Seven Hills Fellowship for some time, you might know that this is version 3.0 of our vision statement. Each of the vision statements that preceded it and this one mean the same thing, but they're just different ways of talking about it. Our prior vision statement is we want to see Rome and all of its communities flourish. That word flourish is in both of those statements. And then our initial vision statement is we want to see the invisible kingdom of God become visible in Rome, Georgia. We want to see the invisible kingdom of God become visible in Rome, Georgia. Now, when Jesus came to earth, he talked about three things. He talked about hell, he talked about money, and then he talked about the kingdom of God. And whenever Jesus talked about the kingdom of God, what we see is that he was doing or undoing the effects of the fall. And so when Jesus talked about the kingdom of God, he then went about undoing the effects of the fall. And so the kingdom is a place where people come under the authority, the rule, and the reign of God, and the effects of sin are undone. Now, in order to know what the effects of sin are, we have to go back to Genesis chapter 3. So I'm going to read Genesis chapter 3, verses 16 through 19, and you'll see the effects of sin there, at least in part. To the woman, he said, this is God speaking to Adam and Eve, I will surely multiply your pain in childbearing. In pain you shall bring forth children. Your desire shall be contrary to your husband, but he shall rule over you. And to Adam he said, because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In pain you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for you are dust, and to dust you shall return. And so if you jump into those verses in Genesis chapter 3, you see that the effects of the fall at a macro level are physical brokenness. We now experience pain. We get sick. We experience death. But not only is there physical brokenness, there's relational brokenness. There's brokenness between Adam and Eve and God. That's spiritual brokenness. There is relational brokenness on a horizontal level. The closest of these human relationships are supposed to be between Adam and Eve, husband and wife, but now there's brokenness in that relationship. There's psychological brokenness. There's vocational brokenness for both Adam and for Eve. And so we look at the world around us here in Rome, Georgia, and we import Jesus talking about the kingdom of God. And we see that as a church, part of what we need to do as a church is be involved in every aspect of the brokenness of Rome, Georgia, bringing healing to each of those areas: physical brokenness, relational brokenness, psychological brokenness, vocational brokenness, and spiritual brokenness. We want to be a church working towards the flourishing of our city. We want to see healing in all of those areas. And so if it were just me, Brian Pierce, saying, here's the vision statement for Seven Hills Fellowship apart from Scripture, I might say something like to know God and make him known. But that would just be a sliver of the Bible's picture of the kingdom of God. When we go back to Scripture, we see that our vision, that any healthy church has to really be targeting all of those different aspects of brokenness in our humanity and in our culture. Now, the last thing that you may have picked up on or noticed in that vision statement is that we want to be a church working towards the flourishing of our city. Now, many churches will basically have a vision statement that talks about their city and America and the ends of the earth. And we very intentionally have said we want to be a church working towards the flourishing of our city, Rome, Georgia. Let me explain that for a minute. First of all, we do support ministries that are around the globe and in other places other than Rome. But primarily, we want to be a church that sees ourselves as a mission agency here in Rome, Georgia. Now, let me talk about that distinction for just a moment. When we lived in a nation that could arguably be called a Christian nation or Christendom, basically a place where the vast majority of people held to a Judeo-Christian worldview, then churches in Christendom could basically say, hey, we're going to do worship and we're going to do these things here, but then we're going to send missionaries out into the world where Christendom doesn't exist. But we now, here in Rome, Georgia, in New York City, in Los Angeles, and across the nation, we live now not in a Christendom context, but in a post-Christian context. And so it's important for churches, and I would argue specifically here for Seven Hills Fellowship, it's important that we understand that our culture here in Rome, Georgia, is actually a post-Christian culture. It's a post-Christian context. And so in a post-Christian context, the church needs to remember that we are God's missionary agency in this place. We need to see ourselves as missionaries here in Rome, Georgia, working towards the flourishing of our city. Now, next week, I'll jump back into more of this, and we'll particularize a bit of how we seek to see that happen. But for a moment, let me just take the time right now, and let's pray. Father, I pray for the people of Seven Hills Fellowship. I pray for Seven Hills Fellowship as a church that we would remain committed to seeing the flourishing of Rome, Georgia, working towards the flourishing of Rome, Georgia, praying towards the flourishing of Rome, Georgia. And Father, I pray that we would remember that that really ultimately only you can see your kingdom come. And so we pray that you would make that happen. But Father, we pray that we would be people who are committed to your glory, to your honor, to the fame of your Son, Jesus. And Father, we pray that we would be committed to the kingdom of God as you seek to undo the effects of the fall in this world that we live in. Father, I pray all these things now in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.